Daga. Celebrating with our pastor and the wife their 10 years of marriage, and from there they're going to also renew their marriage, their vows, and ask strength from God to move forward. So I'm here, having been married for more than the years they have been, I think I qualified to at least say something a little bit about it. So I really want to talk about something that I spoke about not quite a long ago, and I believe that it will be a blessing to many of you gathered here. Amen. And I really want to bear with you all, if you can limit movement, and if you can also give me your attention for the next few minutes, whether married or married. I want to talk about the delusion of the ideal marriage. I get my point. The delusion of the ideal marriage. Because many, not because they have an ideal marriage, but it's because they have a real marriage. So I want to read something from the book of Matthew. Matthew chapter 19. Matthew chapter 19. If the projector can work, I think it can also help us. Matthew chapter 19, verse 3, go in. I can get you somebody to help you if you need somebody to help. Yeah. Ralph and Cole, can you help them? But for the time being, I still need to move on. Hello? Matthew chapter 19, verse 3 says that this tempted him and saying unto him, is it lawful for a man to put away his wife for every cause? He answered and said unto them, have you not read that he which made them at the beginning made them male and female, and said, for this cause shall a man leave his father and mother, and shall cleave to his wife, and they twain shall be one flesh. Wherefore they are no more twain, but one flesh. What therefore God has joined together, let no man put asunder. Verse 7. They say, please don't make me too loud, I beg you. I think what I have is okay. He said, Moses, because of the hardness of your hearts, suffered you to put away your wives. But from the beginning, it was not so. Verse 9. And I say unto you, whosoever shall put away his wife, except it be for fornication, and shall marry another, committeth adultery. And whoso marrieth her which is put away, doth commit adultery. Now I want to read the verse 9 again. The verse 9 says that, I say unto you, whoso shall put away his wife, except it be for fornication, and shall marry another, shall marry another. The word another there is the Greek word allos. The word another over there is the Greek word allos. And please understand me. I need your attention, please. For the next few minutes, I'll be through.
Okay.
Yeah. The word allos. So in fact, what it means is that the Bible is saying that if you put away your wife and you marry another wife, what you have done is you have married another type of the one you are throwing away.
Okay.
And the wife and his have come to this far, not because they know how to marry, but it's because they have the wisdom that what they have is the best for them. Because the scripture here says that if you put away your wife and marry another, you commit adultery. The reason why you are putting away your wife is not enough. Except what he mentioned. Anything that he said that, think about it and consider it carefully. Now, people stay in their marriages and they stretch their neck to look into somebody else's marriage and begin to say, I like that one more than the one that I have. Please, it is not what you think it is. Why are you putting away your wife? Is it because she doesn't know how to talk? Okay. You put her away, go and marry another one who knows how to talk, but doesn't know how to receive business. So you see, another of the same type. Why? The first one I had problems. This was the problem. This one hasn't got this one, but another part. Every wife is good and as well as bad. Every husband is good and as well as bad. So what happens is that when you put away what you have, what you have is another of the same type, not a different type. That is the one reason why people who divorce. Statistics show that people who divorce are 99% remarried. That was after thinking that something better up there. Few minutes. I'm just going to discuss with you about certain things you need to know and understand.
Yeah.
That ideal marriage is a deceptive idea. That's what I'm talking about. The delusion of the ideal marriage. There's nothing like ideal marriage. If you have been watching television, reading some books, and you see all kinds of marriages and you seem to like it, please, it's not like that. When you marry, you are going to meet a wife who doesn't like bathing.
Hey. Yes.
And a husband who doesn't brush his teeth.
Hey.
This is what you are going to meet.
Wow.
So when they do advert and you see nice white teeth and nice spray, and they say, wow, this woman will be good for a wife. I want somebody like this. That's not what it is. So when you marry, what you face, that's how it is. The other marriage, the same thing is what is happening. Accept your own and move ahead with your own. That is how far Pastor Inosa and your wife have come out through 10 years. You are just 2 years and already you are taking plans to divorce. It's not supposed to be so. You are going to meet practical know about this truth. Anytime they marry, they get disappointed after some few years. Yeah, because they read some books. they watch some fruits, or they watch some series on television, maybe The Bold and the Beautiful or something, and then they saw how the man was nice, how the lady will welcome the man. You are welcome from work. Oh, I'm happy. I've missed you. Oh, we are going to travel and go to Alabama, and then we are going to stay there. Please, listen. It is not the case. The case is that you are going to meet a practical person, a practical man who is going to be strong and is going to speak to you and correct you. Who is going to say, no, he can't go to the other place. You are going to meet a wife that when you correct, she will frown her face. You are going to meet a wife who will say that because you didn't send money to my mother, I am not going to open the door for you. Understand that this is what you are going to face.
That's right.
Yeah. If you understand this is how it is, I tell you, you can go far.
Amen.
Than being told that, you know, we're going to marry together, we're going to sit at table, my wife will sit in front here, the husband will sit here, and then on the table, we'll be eating together, we'll look at my wife's face, my wife will look at my face, and we'll use my food to just be touching his food, so that she will know that after the eating, something else must happen. My brother, it's not like that. It's not like that. It's not like that. Yeah, you are going to meet a pastor who will tell you your food is in the fridge. They ask my skin, you didn't come early. Yeah, I come home for you. He said, but what about you? He said, wait, why are you finished? Now you will wait. You are inside the fridge now. I said, I come home for you. I won't do it yourself. I will never let you do it yourself. Then you have to remove your phone. Come and eat it and sit down and eat it because you didn't come home early. So, what has your wife done? Have you done anything wrong? Know that my wife, vocation, that's how she is. So I like her, I accept her, and I move ahead. That is how you move ahead. That because you have married a woman who has lived her lifetime, it will take years for you to understand yourself. So whatever you are going through in your marriage, don't take any decision to divorce. The Bible says if you put away your wife and you go and marry another, you commit adultery. The another is allos, which simply means another of the same kind. Another of the same kind. Maybe the first one will be a slim woman. Maybe the other one will be a fat woman. But it's the same thing.
Yeah.
Another of the same kind.
Yeah.
Maybe the other one knows how to talk, but doesn't know how to cook. Maybe the other one knows how to cook, but doesn't know how to have sex. Maybe the other one knows how to have sex, but she doesn't like having sex frequently. Maybe the other, so there are different things you are going to meet. So you better know what you have. Know what you have. Accept what you have. And move on with what you have. This is how far you can also celebrate your 10th anniversary, your 20th anniversary, your 30th anniversary, your 40th anniversary, your 50th anniversary, your 60th anniversary, your 70th anniversary, your 80th anniversary, your 90th anniversary, your 100th anniversary. Somebody shout hallelujah! Yeah. I came to tell you, your husband is not the worst husband you ever have.
Yeah.
Your husband is not the best. It's not the worst husband. I know my husband. He won't talk about this to me. So I know that he won't talk. So that's how to accept him and move on in life. Yeah. There is no need for you to. This other lady who is making you feel that your wife is the best, is the worst person you have ever married, is deceiving you. Yeah. She is asking you, have you eaten ever since he came from where? You are saying, no, I didn't even meet her in the house. He said, you see, that is why I'm saying that if I had been your wife by now, I would have made sure that you are fed. And when you finish, I will clean your mouth. And I will make sure that I wash your hand for you.
It's not true.
From the day she married, then you say that a ring alarm money or whatever. How did I say it?
A ring
alarm money. Ring alarm money. Is that ring don't enter? If you take it, you can see.
Break it down.
Have some feeling, yes.
Break it down.
I'm breaking it down. I'm sorry. Ecclesiastes chapter 7, verse 13. Ecclesiastes chapter 7, verse 13. Now the scripture says that, consider the work of God, for who can make straight which he hath made crooked? Who can make straight? I want you to understand that we cannot change much.
Very good, I have it.
Yeah, he said, don't make yourself a reagent that is responsible for changing things. You can't change your wife. Neither can you change your husband. So when you live in the marriage and your whole assignment or your whole project is that you are going to change your wife, the best change you can do is for you to just quit out of the whole thing. So don't make it your duty to change. A woman is a woman. Women, they are women. They like talking too much. They talk too much. Yeah. If you tell them, oh, I saw this person whilst I was in the bus. Where was she going? Meanwhile, you were in the bus. You saw the person going. How can you know where she is going? Where was she going? What dress was she wearing? Yeah. Was she talking on telephone? Yeah. What was the hairstyle? Was she holding back? My dear, I saw her. That's what I can say. Yeah, I saw her. That's what I can say. But she will need detail. Say this, talk about this. There's something to say to them. That is how they are. And every woman is like that. They like buying things. They are all like that. It's not a thing for you to get so much flow with the way they are. That is why we advise that before you marry, make sure if you're a Christian, you are married for a Christian. Number two, make sure you really love the person and like the person as well. Yeah, because as time changes, things will also change. Things will also change. Can you still stay with this person? Can you still move ahead with this person? It's the same thing. If you ask them, maybe they will say. But because to them, it's not necessary. It's not a thing for you to bother yourself about. So if he doesn't talk, it's not that he doesn't talk to you, but he talks to others. No. Naturally, he hasn't got much to say. Yeah. He hasn't got much to say. It's likely you will forget the appointment of the next money. You say, don't love your children. Even their birthday, you have forgotten. If you have remembered, remind him a week before. It's not that he doesn't love me. He loves his children. But he's thinking about a lot of things on his head. Yeah. He's thinking about many things on his head. You should not be so much worried about how the men do their things. Because it is said that the best marriage that ever existed on the surface of this earth was a marriage between a blind man, a blind woman, and a dumb man. The woman was blind, but could hear and could talk. Hear. They said they lived and never had quarrels, never had any kind of problem ever in their marriage. Do you know why?
No.
The man was dumb, could not hear. The woman was blind. You know, women can talk.
Okay.
They can insult you.
Yes.
They can make a certain comment. It's better you don't hear. Because if you hear, you will say, pardon? So during the marriage, the woman was always saying all kinds of things about the man. And you are a stupid man. You are a young man. You know they do anything in this house. But the man could not hear, so I was always smiling. And my wife, I love this, that. If you work out for time, if you see young girls, then they look at them. Anytime you go, then they do this. But the man could not hear anything.
Wow.
And then the woman also was blind, but could see. Let me tell you, wives, men can be naughty. Men can misbehave. So if you want your eyes to watch everything, you can be disappointed. Yeah. You can walk with your husband, you will reach the other house, or you get to the other place, you will see the other lady, or the other man, or the other man's wife, he is very happy. Oh, hey, sister, Rosie, oh, you are looking nice. Your hair is bright.
Come, come.
You never embrace me for this house. See how you embrace this girl. Let me find myself. See how you embrace her. Woman, close your eyes. I say what? Close your eyes. If you want to open your eyes, see every movement your husband is making, you will bring trouble for yourself. Because there are certain things it's better you don't know. I said there are certain things it's better you don't know. Let me tell you, every husband loves the wives. Every husband loves the wife. Whether they fight too, whether they don't fight too, whether they have misunderstanding or no misunderstanding, whether the man talks much to the wife or not, he knows the wife. And no man has married the enemy. So maybe other people will just be, you know, floating around as if they are going to take your husband from you. The husband is not a fool. He knows who the wife is. So please, ladies, you create problem by your eyes. Everything you are watching him, you go for a program. Your wife, your eye is on your husband. Every movement he makes. When he picks the phone, he's calling. You are watching him. When he goes to banyo, you are, please. Leave the man. He loves you. He will not leave you. Close your eyes. If you open your eye on every matter, you will bring trouble to yourself. Think about the practical, you see, and the marriage that is real. Yeah, you might not like what I'm saying. I say that, hey, you know, so I've seen one before. If you don't open your eye, let me say before, really, don't take our blessing. Nobody will take her. Nobody will take her. Build some trust in him. When you build a trust in him, it will be difficult for him to break the trust you have built in him. That for you to become suspicious about the man is an external being. And then the woman is an internal being. God created the man from what was outside, the dust, the soil. And then the woman was created from that which was already created. He took it. The man is attracted by external things. They like things like pencil, television, a nice car, a beautiful, gorgeous, voluptuous, scintillating, I have to watch that and tell them, this is my church member. That is my church member. By the grace of God. Yeah, I have almost thousands of church members. Yeah. I mean, real church members. Not I'm talking about people I don't know. People who are in my church. Yeah. All over Rome, Napoli, Torino, Milano, everywhere you go. I have to watch them. It's for the matter of making sure they are my church members. But the real matter is that I'm a man. I'm a man. So when I see outside, look at it, and I give glory to God. I look at it, and I give glory to God. And if you look carefully, the woman too is not attracted by how you look, but attracted by what she hears. By what she hears.
Yeah, because he's an internal being. Yeah. Was taken from the inside. Yeah. Inside. So what they hear in their ear, that gets into their heart, is what pleases them. Yeah. That's not that you can find a stupid man getting a very nice, beautiful lady. Yeah. Why? Because he was able to speak. He was able to say things which entered into the woman. Yeah. So what I'm saying is that a lot of things about the man you should know. A lot of things about the woman you should know. It is not that, your husband is this or is that. Please, if you do that, you can't survive. Marriage is forever. Boss, give me Ecclesiastes chapter 9, verse 9. Ecclesiastes 9, 9. And look at what the scripture says. Ecclesiastes chapter 9, verse 9. The scripture says that. The scripture says, it says, live joyfully with the wife whom thou lovest all the days of the life of thy vanity, which he had given thee under the sun, all the days of thy vanity, for that is thy portion in this life, and in thy labor which thou takest under the sun. So the scripture says that, choose to live joyfully with the wife whom thou lovest all the days of your life. Your life of what? Of vanity. It's a useless life. Yeah. It's a vile life. So why do you live and instead of you having joy in your marriage, every day fighting, your wife is from the sea and you are also from where? You, the man, you are also from where? It's other sea, or you are from where?
From the bush.
From the bush.
Yeah.
Yeah, your wife is from the sea, you're also from the bush. But you married her. So why cause all kinds of misunderstanding? The scripture says, leave choice. You put a lot of that there. And they ask you, choose. You close your eyes or you open it. You choose. When you choose, he is the one you have.
Okay.
That's what you have. Yeah. So decide to, this is your portion. Decide to live with it the rest of your life. In fact, there is no much peace in divorce. There is no much peace in divorce. Yeah. That is why I will tell you, in case you are not married,
take your time.
If you are not married, take your time. Be convinced very well before you marry. Because when you marry, it's forever. Never think of divorce. When you marry, the portion you get, accept it. Live with it. Die with it. Now, because it's so unfortunate that the marriages that don't work these days are Christian marriages.
Yeah.
The marriages that don't work these days are Christian marriages. Hey, I thought you was a pastor. Listen. Spirits, they don't marry. Spirits, they don't marry. It's the flesh. So aside the man being a pastor, find out whether you're okay about selling this. Because when you marry, it's not the pastorate you marry. You will marry the real man. You marry the real man. He said, and the two shall be one flesh, not one spirit. He didn't say the two shall be one spirit. He said the two shall be one flesh. You are going to marry the flesh of the man and the flesh of the woman. So everything about the man, don't say, he calls himself a Christian, he calls himself a pastor. I never knew, because he didn't marry the spirit of the man. Neither did you marry the spirit of the woman. And when they become Christian, it's only their spirit that is born again. But the flesh is the same. The flesh is the same. So know this truth. In order to be able to maintain your marriage, to maintain your marriage, that is so peaceful, as people say. Marriage is full of foolishness. It's full of all kinds of battles. So you need God, and you need the church, and you need the power. pastor to preach every day, to do something about the marriage. Yeah, it is not something that when you get in natural, then you move on like that. It's full of challenges. It's full of valleys. It's full of mountains. It's full of dust. It's full of rivers. It's full of snow. It's full of tornado. It's full of many kinds of things. You really need to understand that marriage is not as smooth. That because now you are disappointed. Because you are expecting a smooth marriage, but it's not smooth. That's what I'm saying, that it's a delusion for you to think of ideal marriage. That's not exist. Bro, give me 1 Corinthians 7:28.
Preach!
1 Corinthians 7:28. I have just 10 minutes to end my preaching. 1 Corinthians 7:28. The scripture says that. And if thou marry, thou hast not sinned. And if a virgin marry, she has not sinned. Nevertheless, such, can you see? Such one shall have what? Trouble in the flesh. And I spare you.
Richard.
I don't understand why you marry, I don't want to. Yeah. Why do you marry if you don't want trouble? As a parent, it's full of trouble. It's full of nonsense. Yeah. If you accept it, then you will not see the nonsense.
Okay.
You will not hear the nonsense. You move on. Love each other. Press on to death do you apart. But if you are too melancholic, you want things to be straight. It's not straight. Your husband cannot come home every day at 7 o'clock.
Oh, okay.
It's like he closes 6:45. By 7, sharp. He must be at home. No. There are times you will come home late.
Yeah. Preach it.
Yeah. You come home late. Yeah. It's a practical thing to eat. Yeah. Yes, he will also not have his dinner every day by 7.
Mm.
There are times there will not be any dinner at all.
It's true.
It's normal. He couldn't cook day. No problem. Go buy pizza. Maybe you eat it. Maybe you eat that. Why not do this, sir? You know, if you come home early today, oh, no problem, sir. I don't need any reason. You let's move on. I trust you. You trust me. You are my portion. I'm your portion.
Let's
go. You go. Yeah, you move on. You move on. If you have trouble, meet your pastor. Yeah, such a nice pastor like Pastor Inosa. You just meet him. He will advise you. If you meet the wife, oh, every day smiling. You change your mind about your decision to put him away or to put her away. And you move on. Yeah. You will have trouble saying, if you marry, you have not done anything wrong. Nevertheless, such shall have trouble in the flesh. Such shall have trouble in the flesh. You shall have trouble.
I'm married this day. Husband, make sure you wear pajamas to sleep. Ladies, wear. Yeah. Okay. When you are walking, make sure you move step by step. Okay. Every day, eat together. Okay. When you go to church, sit together. Maybe this is what you have been hearing. But how many of these things have been working? That I'm telling you that which is practical. That this is what you shall eat. This is what is the real one. So that you accept it. And know this is what I've been giving. And you walk with it. You move with it. That is how come they have come this far. Oh yeah, they have come this far. Because they accept each other. They accept each other. Yeah, they accept each other. It's not that this man is dead. No, like, the way you are, I like you. The way I am. If your wife is too fat, she's too big. Please. I don't know whether when you were marrying her, she was big or she was this fat. Remember, you took the vow to live with her forever. If your husband has spots belly,
okay.
Now you feed her. No, sir. Now you feed her. Now you feed her. Yeah. 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 He said, eat meat. Eat meat. Tell me you eat meat. Meanwhile, it is around 10 p.m. You are telling him, eat meat. And the eat meat, first day you go to work. your portion. That's your portion. I said, that's your portion.
Yes.
No, please. You see, as I conclude my message, marriage is not in heaven. It's just a temporal arrangement on this earth. So please, accept the one you have. Make it better. Live with it. Be happy with it. The scripture said, live joyfully. Don't be unhappy all the time because of your wife's character or because of your husband's character. Forget about those things. Serve God, go to church, and live with him, and live with her. Don't make it your duty to change because you cannot change. I said you cannot change him. You cannot change your husband. Neither can your husband change your wife. What you have is the portion God gave to you. And remember, such talking is because the women are, I don't take nonsense women. Yeah. You are a woman, you don't take nonsense. You cannot live in the marriage. Because marriage is full of nonsense. Have you forgotten? It was Job who told the wife, you are a foolish woman. Abigail said about the husband, he told David, my husband is a fool. He's a fool. My dad doesn't care. That's why you behave like that. Now it's full of these things. You shall have trouble. The trouble that will be every day you are fighting. What it means is that you will trouble to accept some of the things he does. And these shall also trouble, he will battle in the flesh to accept some of the things. So it's like, for me alone, I wouldn't have done this thing this way. But this is what my husband wants. And they say, woman, be submissive. So I will submit myself to this thing that he is doing, even though it gives me trouble, but I'll accept it and I'll flow with it. I'll accept it and I'll flow with it. I'll accept it and I'll flow with it. That is why I said, sex shall have what? Trouble. The trouble being that you are going to have to battle in the flesh to be able to accept certain things that you are going to see in the marriage. It is very important for us to know that if you put away your wife or you put away your husband and you marry another, you commit adultery. And the another is alos, which is another of the same kind. Another of a similar problem to what you are running away. The reason why you are leaving your spouse, the one you are going to marry, has another, but in a different way. So you better stay with what you have. That is how come they have come this far. And that is how come they are going to go far. They are going to have more celebrations because they have learned to accept what God has given to them. If you accept what God has given to you, yeah, you will do well. Look at Romans chapter 18, chapter 12, verse 18. Romans chapter 12, verse 18. It's my last scripture. If it be possible, as much as lieth in you, live peaceably with all men. As I conclude this, I want to say, in our marriages, please, let us try as much as possible to live peaceably with our spouses. It's a choice we have to make. Because you can have storms all over every day. But you know, there was an alternative that could have brought about peace. But I didn't choose that one. And I choose that which has brought about this problem. So I want to say to all of you, before you say something to your spouse, or before you do something, ask this thing that I'm about to do. Will it bring peace? Will it bring peace? If it will not bring peace, then I shouldn't say it. If it will not bring peace, then I shouldn't do it. Because the Bible says, as
this happened with him, how much more my husband? Or how much more my wife? How much more my spouse? Choose. If you don't have peace in your marriage, it's a choice you have made. Husbands and wives, listen to me. If you don't have peace in your marriage, like Pastor Inosa and the wife have the peace, I saw them with a certain car. I said, what car is this? My wife was telling me, look at the car, how nice it is. What do you think about it? I said, what do I think he wants it? He said, let's not start. No, Pastor Inosa, you've done something beautiful. No, you have done something beautiful. You are such a nice person. Yeah. With your wife, you have done great things. As much as lies in you, choose peace. I said choose peace. Even when your friend does something against you, there are two ways. Either you go call hunger. I hear say this. I won't find out. If you saw it there, or you know this so. Okay, you know this so. Then you settle it. Peace. Okay, I hear say, you do this. Eh? I don't want you. Now you say every day. Then didn't choose the peace aspect. Everything that happens, there are many methods of dealing with it. Always choose the peace one. Ladies, find a nice way to ask your husband questions. Don't accuse them. Don't attack them.
All
right. Because the things you hear, not all of them are true. That person who has been giving you information, how best and how good is her marriage?
Richard.
Somebody who is a divorcee is giving you advice, and you are taking the advice and you want to apply it in your marriage. Does it make sense?
Yes.
I said, does it make sense?
No.
I mean, somebody who has no hair on his head is selling medicine. He said the medicine gives hair. Who go buy? Selling medicine. Hey, then he show you pictures of what the medicine has done. See, I see this picture. This will be 3 months. This will be 6 months. 1 year, if you use one, your life, you say, go reach here. As he is talking, he is taking his handkerchief and his wife with it. They're sweating on his head. Why? Because there is no hair on his head. Such a person is selling medicine. That is the medicine you have bought. He couldn't handle his marriage. He couldn't handle her marriage. And he's pumping you with ideas. He's telling you, as a man, they are not pillows. You cannot lie with them. A man is not a pillow. It's like a stone. You can't put your head on a man. So be very wise. Hey, as a man, every man likes women. Everything watch him. If you get police, if you're a full carrier, if you're a good police, he's spoiling your marriage. That God will touch his heart. That you will do that which is right. And you will not do that which is wrong. Pray for him. Pray for him all the time. Because he is the head. He is the deciding factor. He is the leader. He is the pilot. He is the man who is holding the steer. So if you don't submit to him, you are supposed to submit to him. So you are going to follow it. But I believe as you trust your husband, as you pray for him, oh, God will make him a better person. Amen. Let us take care of our wives. Let's love them. Yeah, the Bible says in 1 Peter, it says that dwell with them according to knowledge. It says dwell with them according to knowledge. You have to study women. Read about women. Know them. Know the type of married. Whether she is a sanguine or steady her. And know what makes her happy and what does not make her happy. Know all these things and live with them. Protect them. Cover them. Provide for them. When they need this, buy for them. Yeah. Because they like it. Buy for them. If you cannot buy, explain.
That's right.
If you can't buy one, explain. I can't buy this one. Yeah. But don't see them as people who are this or that, if they don't know and live with them, please don't drop them. Don't drop them. Don't leave them.
thou marriest, and that this man may well. That's your portion. Live peacefully with her. Ladies and gentlemen, I told you I was going to preach about the delusion of the ideal marriage. The ideal marriage doesn't exist. What exists is a practical marriage where you are going to face all kinds of problems. But if you will keep your marriage, I see you keep your marriage. I see the Lord helping you. I see the Lord protecting you. I see the Lord strengthening you. I see you also having your 10 years anniversary. Maybe your 25 years anniversary. Your 50th year anniversary of marriage. Your 75 year anniversary of marriage. I see you and your husband growing and becoming old. I see you and your husband asking which of us will go first. And I see your husband say, we shall go together, Oga. We shall go together. Somebody put your hands together. And you will. are here this evening, you know you need the grace of God in your marriage. Please, I will not call you forward so that you might think because of that you don't want to raise your hand. If you think you need the grace of God, at least to live to be 10 years in your marriage and become 25, become 50 and 75. Maybe you are not married, but you want that grace to be upon you the day you also marry. If you are here like that, maybe you are also married, but you need that grace of God. Wherever you are, lift up your hand. Wherever you lift up your hand, you need the grace of God in your marriage. You pass through 10 years, go through 25, go through 50, go through 75. Oh Lord, I pray, Lord, behold the hands lifted up. We need your grace. We need your grace, Lord, to live together as couples and to get to the very end, the end of the road, where you shall do us apart by death. Deliver every hand lifted up from any marriage that is at the verge of breaking. Deliver us from it in the name of Jesus. I pray for the grace to live joyfully and peaceably with our spouses, Lord. The grace comes from above. The help comes from above. So I pray that you shall help us, especially the unmarried ones. Give them wisdom to choose. Give them wisdom to accept who has to be accepted. Deliver them from deception. Deliver them from delusion. Deliver them from counterfeit husbands and wives. Give them the right partners so that they will lead and serve you. I pray especially for Pastor Inosa and the wife, Lord, that you shall take them to the 25th anniversary. You shall take them to the 50th anniversary. You shall take them to the 75th anniversary. And you shall take them to heaven. I want to say thank you, Lord, for hearing us in the name of Jesus. Finally, you are here. Maybe you don't know Jesus. Maybe you have not given your life to Jesus. You don't know him as your Lord and personal Savior. You are not a born again Christian. In Jesus' name we have prayed, and all the saints of God shall say, Amen. Amen. You are heading to somebody, and you may have your seat in the presence of the Lord. Hallelujah. Amen.
Every Sunday, the reception, I mean, we commence. Just relax and wait for the real thing. Praise the Lord. And I want to take the honor to invite Pastor Dan to bless the offering. Immediately, he blessed on the offering. Our minister will come immediately to continue the dedication and blessing of the marriage. Praise the living God. Sorry.
Father, we give you thanks today for Jesus. We thank you for the opportunity given to us to present and offer you your blessings. Father, every heart that I give offer here will cover in the blood of Jesus. Those that did not give too much for them, bless them as well. So that one day they come into your presence, they can also be blessed. Lord, we give you glory. In Jesus' name we pray. Father, thank you, shout out, amen.
Thank you very much, sir.
The nearest place to hell on this earth is the house where hatred, bitterness, and quarrels prevail. As such, the Lord build a hope of love, peace, and joy in the Holy Ghost. We know that we build in vain. It is for this reason that these two persons, Mr. and Mrs. Sinosa, have come again to renew and to affirm their love and commitment to this holy estate of matrimony. At this time, I'm going to charge Pastor Reverend Inosa. Do you affirm your unconditional love and commitment to your wife and his? Do you promise to continue living together after God's ordinance in holy matrimony, in holy estate? Will you encourage her? Will you honor her? Will you keep her and do not allow any circumstance to affect you, your faithfulness to her, so long as you both live? If you do, say, yes, I do.
Yes, I do.
Put your hands together, hallelujah. It's so beautiful. It's so nice. Sister Hayes, do you affirm your unconditional love, your submission? Do you promise to continue living together after God's ordinance in the holy estate of matrimony? Will you encourage him? Will you honor and keep him? Not allow any circumstance to affect your faithfulness to him, so long as you both shall live. If you do, say, yes, I do.
Yes, I do. It is just
you are supposed to face each other. You are already facing each other. I want you to say this after me. You just mention your name, Pastor Inosa, and then you repeat the rest of the things I'm going to say. So you are going to renew your vow. So say, I. Mention your full name.
Pastor Inosa William Simi.
Having chosen you. Mention her name.
His. Williams.
Among all.
And having married you. This day.
I renew my vows.
To you.
Mention her name again.
His. Williams.
I offer myself. Completely.
To you.
As your wedded husband.
I promise to love you.
With all my heart.
And to be faithful.
I promise.
To stand by you always.
In times of joy.
In times of trials.
And in times of sorrow.
I dedicate our marriage.
Our hope. To the Lordship.
Of Jesus Christ.
I pledge myself.
And all that I am.
To this eternal covenant.
So help me God.
Somebody put your hands together for me. Sister Hayes, you're also going to mention your full name.
I am his Williams.
Having chosen you,
Musakai Williams.
And having married you this day. I renew my vow to you. That in response to your love for me.
I will offer myself.
In the beauty.
Of submission.
To you.
As your wife.
Special. Today we renew their purpose. Let them remain forever a symbol of your love and commitment to each other. Shall we pray? Father, we ask you to redeem these rings once again with the blood of Jesus. Bless this couple with a fresh blessing that their love may be renewed as they wear them. Let them be a sign that these two shall as they live. In Jesus' name we are praying. Amen. Okay. So Pastor Yosa, I give this one to you. Okay. Mention the first name of your wife 3 times. Then you say this after me. Just her first name.
His. His. His.
Bye. This ring. It's an expression.
Of all I have promised you.
I give it
I give it
with all my love,
with all my love,
with all my life,
with all my life,
and with all my commitment,
and with all my commitment.
I therefore give you this ring.
I therefore give you this ring.
In the name of the Father,
in the name of the Father,
and of the Son,
and of the Son,
and of the Holy Spirit,
and of the Holy Spirit.
Put it there. Wow, wow. Oh, somebody put your hands together. Hallelujah. Amen. If you have this on my ear, yeah. So you mentioned the first name of your husband 3 times, and he said this after me.
Nosakai, Nosakai, Nosakai.
Hallelujah.
This ring
is an expression.
It's an expression
of all I have promised you.
Of all I have promised you.
I give it.
I give it
with all my love.
With all my love.
And lifelong commitment.
A lifelong commitment.
I give you this ring.
I give you this ring.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
And of the Son.
And of the Son.
And of the Holy Spirit.
And of the Holy Spirit.
Somebody put your hands together. At this time, Pastor Inosa, you are going to help your wife to kneel down. And then I call the minister to come for us to do that. So you help her to kneel down. You face this way.
Of God and the woman of God, I know, Lord, more power has come, more grace has come. So we just want to conclude by saying thank you for what you have done for them. In the name of Jesus. And all the saints of God shall say amen. Man of God, God bless you so much. You can do a fun and have it. Pastor Idosa, you get up. I didn't take the time to help you to get up. Pastor Idosa, get up. Let you help your affable wife. God bless you. Amen. All right then. We are still moving on in the next 10 minutes. For as much as Mr. and Mrs. Idosa Williams have openly renewed their vows to God and to each other today and have declared their intention to keep and maintain this marriage, it is my privilege as a minister of the Lord Jesus Christ to pronounce you a husband and a wife afresh in the name of the Father and of the Son of the Holy Spirit. Oh, put your hands together. Put your hands together. Amen. At this time, they are already facing each other. I'm going to ask the man to salute the wife. Hallelujah. Yeah. As a redeemer. And your wife. Trust in the Lord and do good. He shall cause you to be established in the land, and he shall provide for you. Say amen. Amen. Delight yourself in the Lord, and he shall give you the desires of your heart. Commit your ways unto the Lord. And trust him, and he shall bring it to pass. Say amen. I break down the walls of opposition, walls of resistance that are lifted up against your life and your peace. I reverse, I nullify, I cancel, I reject every unscriptural prayer and death wish against your life. Say amen. I resist the desire of the enemy to see your downfall. I superimpose the will of God over and against every setback, every limitation, every disappointment of your life. Say amen. May your lives be extended. May your days be prolonged. May the rest of your years together be sweeter and better than the ones that are past. May the blessing of God replace every curse. Say amen. A new horizon be upon your life. May the goodness and the favor of the Lord shine upon you in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. May the Lord be your helper. May the Lord be your son. May the Lord be the shade. May the Lord be the rain. May the Lord be the dew. Oh, may they call you blessed. May you live to see your children's children. Bless other marriages. May you have the power to renew other marriages. May Almighty
Yeah. your stomach, please don't leave. God bless you.
Please, we are going to pray. I am going to beg for a total silence in the house because God is still around. Let's give him that honor. Father, I thank you in the name of Jesus. I celebrate you for this wonderful occasion, raising your son and your daughter to renew and rededicate their marriage before you. Lord, I thank you for what you have done. Thank you, thank you, oh God. All we could say is thank you. It has been you all along, and we celebrate you. Thank you, Father. And as we close, you are still with us. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Those things later. So, ladies and gentlemen, I welcome you all to this great occasion once again. I am your humble son, your friend, MC The Wind, known as Miracle, all the way from Emilia, Romagna. I have been privileged to be the master of today's ceremony. So please, whatever I say here today, I'm not commanding anyone, but I'm doing my job. Just try to work with me so that we can work hand in hand. That is what the English people do call work in pari passu. So ladies and gentlemen, number one on my list, we have the ushering and the welcoming of all members of the high table. So ladies and gentlemen, please, even if your name is not being mentioned to the high table, does not make you feel less privileged, or you are not important, or rather those that have been called are important, you are important, they are important than you know. But we just have to mention some few people to just make this occasion to be a fulfilled and a successful one. So ladies and gentlemen, we are all important. Even in the sight of God, we are all equal. So if your name is not being mentioned, just take it as one of those things that do happen in our ceremony, because we all cannot sit in the high table. Hello? This great occasion. Please, can we clap for her, please? Where is she? Osamui Ebohon, my mommy, you are welcome. Thank you.
Hallelujah. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, fathers and mothers, brothers and sisters, friends and well-wishers, colleagues from far and near, from all over the world. You are all welcome to this place this evening. It's a great day, isn't it? It's a wonderful day. If you are not enjoying this group, I am. Hallelujah. It is the day the Lord has made, and he said we should rejoice and be glad in it. Above all, more reasons to rejoice and be glad in it, because we are celebrating our brother and his wife. Their 10th year anniversary is a great day. It is a wonderful day that you normally hear or that you usually listen to. But never mind, a new thing is coming your way this evening.
Amen.
A great thing is coming your way this evening.
Amen.
I am sorry if I will be offending some of our accepted with me, and God will bless you. God be free and prove by all.
Emmanuel, 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 Emmanuel,
tail. That was a nice one.
Inshallah.
Am I correct in Arab?
to this occasion is none other person than Mr. and Mrs. Nasa Williams, all the way from Modena. DJ, roll us the music as you welcome them, please, as they come outside. If you know you love what you are doing today, you're going to rise on your feet and give them that respect because today is their day. Please don't feel too big, don't feel too small. Just give them that respect. As they are walking out, you rise on your feet. If you have money, you can spray them. If you have a seat, no problem, spray them. If you have water, you can spray them.
Battle Center.
So, DJ, are you ready? Let's go. One, two, three, go.
Yes,
should be getting ready for your dance. Special representation by Nina Dance Group. Are you both ready? Please, people should get ready for your dance so that we can move on to the next on the list. The Star Majesty should be getting ready as well.
Anything you want, pass me.
is their marriage anniversary, so they are filled with joy. Both of them want to, they want to exaggerate and exaggerate their happiness to us. So we will watch them, and after the dance, I will ask you people who win for the dance. So, Mr. DJ, are you ready? Celebrant, please, are you for?
But now, I tell you, many people when they talk say,
If you see the shark, you see the deck, you go kill shark. But now, now, there's another solution. The reason the last thing tell me, now time, I didn't ask question. Very soon, I will follow. Very soon, I will follow. Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
down. Please let us do the cutting of the cake. I beg you. To do the cutting of the cake. So give me the J.
J.
Give me the E.
E.
Give me the X.
X.
Give me the U.
U.
Give me the X.
X.
And what is that?
G.
Congratulations, Pastor Mr. This is Mr. Williams. All your saints here, marriage and congratulations. Please let us give you one hand. Let's go and close, please. The wine, the wine. Thank you. Ask me people, they want to come share a cup and wine for us for this thing. Take care, God bless you. Please share the wine around, but remember I share the wine around. Don't do the toasting. So we can do general dance. Thank you, God bless you. Where ask me people? Ask you, where are they?
The cake.
problem with shop, oh, please, you push go and tell me I'm at all time. Go and cross the cake, bring his children for it or inside. I'm gonna open and go ask. I'm gonna go cut the cake. I'm gonna go cut a call. Me and you would have a jail at all time. The men that I call, DJ, I'm gonna give us that music as we wait for the men to come and present their gift.
Yes, what a woman can do, a man can do better.
Thank you. Oh,
church right now. Don't need to go out. Babylon City. And touch the floor with a telegram. Thank you and God bless you. Yeah.
warmth all over my body is not enough for me to say thank you to the God that created heaven and the earth. He is the one that made this day possible. Because today marks 10 years of our marriage, and we are celebrating our 10 years marriage anniversary. I so much appreciate my friends and well-wishers, my family members, my husband, family, people that came to celebrate with us. May heaven reward you people in the name of Jesus. In fact, God has been so faithful to us in our family, in my marriage. 2006, we got married. 2007, we have our first child. 2010, we have our second child. 2014, we have our third child. We have three boys. In fact, we are so happy. We are so happy. I so want to thank everybody that came to celebrate with us from afar, from near. May heaven reward people in Jesus' name.
To this occasion. So tell us, introduce yourself and tell us how you see the occasion today.
Okay, good evening. Well, I'm a sister to the groom and an immediate sister to him.
Your name?
And my name is Miss Esther Tete Williams. And today I'm so happy. I'm overwhelmed being here today, celebrating with my brother and his lovely wife on their 10th year anniversary. And I may say I'm very, very happy today. Well, I would like to use this opportunity to thank everyone that raised this station today. And I pray God to you. Continue to bless them and fulfill their heart desires for them. Okay. So, well, God is not enough for me to express my feelings today. But I thank you.
You're welcome. Good evening.
I want to ask you a minute. First of all, I want to thank you for coming.
You're welcome.
Today's occasion.
Well,
I want to ask you, how did you find the occasion?
It is groovy. They really tried. I want to say a very big thanks to them because calling and at the same time entertaining is not easy. Some people will call and you not get entertained, you understand? So I want to say I really enjoyed myself today. I and my group, we enjoyed ourselves.
Thank you very much. I want to ask, are you a friend of the husband or your friend with the wife?
So the wife.
The wife.
Yeah, my friend to the wife.
And sorry, I didn't ask you earlier on, what is your name, so that then for the records we can...
My name is Evelyn Okunkwanwa, the president of the Purity Mothers Club.
Okay. Thank you very much. And I wish you celebration upon celebration.
Amen.
Celebrate with us.
Amen.
Jesus.
Amen. And I want to wish, though they've been happy, more blessings, love, and may God grant them their heart desire in Jesus' name.
Yourself a little bit so that we know who you are and how you are related to the husband and the wife.
primarily contributed a lot to my coming to Europe. That is why I have to honor highly this invitation. Definitely when they came to Nigeria, I see me and they just decided that it's safe for me to come to Europe when they came to do their traditional marriage. Definitely the traditional marriage they came to do in Nigeria contributed to my coming to Europe. If it cost me anything to come and celebrate with them, I'm ready to spend anything for them.
Okay.
Thank you
very much. I hope the occasion, I mean, was good. Everything went well.
The occasion is excellent. Excellent.
Thank you.
The occasion, the marriage is worthy of the pleasure because if you see me,
Jesus' name. Amen.